Hi, I'll give you now an example of a pill with a radius R which diffuses into the surroundings. So we assume that at the surface of the pill we have a concentration CR, and somewhere far away at a radius R we assume that the concentration in infinity will go to C infinity. So in fact we have here pure diffusion, we have a pill, and the material is diffusing around. Well, how do we solve this problem? Because we want to know the concentration gradient around this pill. Well, then we start with Fourier's law, writing down that the mass flow rate is equal to the diffusion coefficient multiplied by the surface area of the sphere, 4 pi r squared, multiplied by the concentration gradient. In fact, we have to solve this equation assuming that the mass flow is constant. So in this case, we could write down minus dc is equal to phi m divided by 4 pi multiplied by the diffusion coefficient, 1 over r squared dr. Now we integrate at both sides and we obtain c is phi m divided by 4 pi multiplied by d, 1 over r. The minus, I had a minus here and a minus on the right side, but we have not to forget the integration constant. So we have now an equation with an integration constant, and we could wonder what is the value of the integration constant. Well, if this term goes to infinity, we get c infinity. So in this case, we could write down c minus c infinity is equal to phi m divided by 4 pi multiplied by d, 1 over r. And you see that we have now a concentration distribution which shows that if r the radius becomes, it drops down. But we could also write another integration constant, because at the surface, at r is r, it's also cr. So another equation will be cr minus c infinity is equal to phi m by 4 pi d, 1 over r. You see that in both equations, this is 1 over r, this is 1 over the large one. If we now divide this equation, if we take this equation, let's say this is equation 1, and we take equation 2, then you can divide 1 by 2, and then you get c minus c infinity divided by cr minus c infinity is r over r. Well, this is an interesting result, because without knowing anything about the diffusion or the mass flow rate, we already know how the dimensionless distribution, concentration distribution, around the sphere is. So if we draw now the distribution around the sphere, we will see that it will have 1 over r relationship, starting with, of course, cr, because here r is r. So you now see that you can derive it by yourself, and even you can have a dimensionless profile which already gives you a feeling how it works. You could also take an equation 1, and then you directly see 1 is dependent on the diffusion coefficient and the mass flow rate. This is an example how you can work out a pure diffusion problem. Thanks for your attention.